Hello students, welcome to the 49th class on current affairs, and in this class I will be dealing with a very important issue, that is open access policy or open access scheme. Now this relates to the power sector because this policy was announced in Electricity Act 2003. 2003 mein is policy ko announce kiya gaya. इस क्लास में हम अंडरस्टैंड करेंगे कि तो बैकग्राउंड इसका कि ये पॉलिसी क्यों आया. सेकेंडली विल बी अंडरस्टैंडिंग द लैकुनास इन दिस पॉलिसी और सरकार व्हाट द गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग इन ऑर्डर टू एड्रेस द इश्यूज रिलेटेड टू दिस ओपन एसेस पॉलिसी. नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सेक्टर इन इंडिया. नाउ व्हेन इट कम्स टू द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सेक्टर इन इंडिया, it was actually dominated by government or there was a kind of monopoly of the government in the electricity sector. When it comes to transmission, when it comes to distribution, so these entire channels of power distribution were primarily owned by government. But in 2003 government had come out with an act, that is Electricity Act 2003. Now this had brought about a transcendental change in the power sector, in the power generation, in the power transmission and in the power distribution. Now the most important thing that was introduced by this was competition in the electricity sector. Pehle electricity sector mein koi competition nahi tha. ये आने के बाद, इलेक्ट्रिसिटी एक्ट 2003 आने के बाद पावर सेक्टर में बहुत सारा कंपटीशन जनरेट कर दिया गवर्नमेंट ने. प्राइमरली क्या किया, गवर्नमेंट ने अलाउ कर दिया जितने भी बड़े लोगों को रिक्वायरमेंट है, बड़े लोगों को मीन्स जिनको पावर ज्यादा का रिक्वायरमेंट है, दैट इज अबव 1 मेगावाट से ज्यादा का पावर रिक्वायरमेंट है, बड़े कस्टमर्स, बिग कस्टमर्स, दे कैन एक्चुअली चूज फ्रॉम द कंपनीज दैट आर एक्चुअली ट्रांसमिटिंग द इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. सो बिग कस्टमर्स हु आर इन नीड ऑफ मोर पावर, दे कैन एक्चुअली गेट इन टच विद द ट्रांसमिशन कंपनीज एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द ट्रांसमिशन नेटवर्क इज एक्चुअली ओन्ड बाय द गवर्नमेंट. सो ट्रांसमिशन नेटवर्क से सीधा जाके एक प्राइस डिसाइड करेंगे कि आपको शॉर्ट टर्म, मीडियम टर्म, लॉन्ग टर्म कितना पावर का रिक्वायरमेंट है एंड अकॉर्डिंगली गवर्नमेंट विल गिव देम अ प्राइस. एनी कंपनी दैट विल बी इन द ट्रांसमिशन बिजनेस विल गिव देम अ प्राइस कि किस प्राइस के ऊपर उनको इलेक्ट्रिसिटी अवेलेबल कराना है. बट when it comes to this open access policy, this was introduced for the competition, this was introduced for the betterment of the big customers who were in need of more electricity. But this had a very important fault in it. What was that important fault? That important fault was when it comes to the agreement, short term agreement, medium term agreement and long term agreement between the customer and the company that were offering the power, those agreements were not fulfilled. Now what it means? It means the customers used to rescind on the agreements. Now what is the meaning of rescinding on the agreement? It means that they were not fulfilling their agreement of buying the power from the transmission company or from the generating company, the company that was generating the electricity. ये क्यों करते थे? देखिए, अगर मार्केट में आपको चीज सस्ता मिल रहा है, यू विल नॉट गो इन फॉर बाइंग एट अ हायर प्राइस. सो कस्टमर जितना रहता है इलेक्ट्रिसिटी सेक्टर में, दे यूज टू एक्चुअली गो इन फॉर टू बाय फ्रॉम द डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन कंपनीज. जब भी देखिए, इकोनॉमी का साइकिल है, दिस इज अ वन फुल ईयर इकोनॉमिक साइकिल. इन वन ईयर समटाइम्स द प्राइसेस विल बी हाई एंड समटाइम्स द प्राइसेस विल बी लो. Sometimes will be high and sometimes it will be low. So the customers used to actually shift. Sometimes they used to get it directly from the transmission companies Or sometimes they used to go back to the distribution companies. So there was a lot of flip and flops on the part of the distribution companies and the transmission companies. Agar zyada aap transmission company se le rahe hain, so the price of the distribution company used to go down. If you're buying more from the distribution companies, the price used to actually go up. So this was creating trouble for both these subsectors of the power, that is transmission and distribution. So transmission or distribution dono ka development nahi ho paya, and that was something that has led to the losses of the power sector and open access policy. Jiska, now another important thing, agar open access policy ka kya matlab hai? Open access policy is primarily from the perspective of the distributor or the transmitter. It is not from the purview of the customer. Now, open access doesn't mean that anyone has the right to choose from where they want to buy electricity. Open access primarily, as per open access policy, means that the transmitter and the distributor companies, they can sell their electricity to the customers who are big customers, who want it above the range of 1 megawatt. Now, government, under the proposed amendment to the Electricity Act, will be bringing about changes in the open access policy. Now, what government is doing? Pehle, sirf bade log, jo bada customer jiska requirement hai, they can choose it from the transmission company or the distribution company. But now this will be allowed even for the smaller customers who are in need of a lesser amount of power. So this will actually benefit the competition in the power sector. And secondly, another important change that the government is willing to bring about is that the company should not be allowed to rescind on their agreement, on their promises. Because this brings about fluctuations. Kabhi to transmission sector wale ko zyada fayda ho jata tha, kabhi distribution wale ko. Usse power ka jo ek sustainable way mein development hona chahiye, wo development nahi ho pata. Now, in order to read more on this open access policy, this is a very important policy. You can just read the text provided along with this video, or you can visit brainyias.com for the same. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.